Hello friends, welcome to Mac Exam today. Today we are going to do puzzles. This is also an important topic for banking exams or any competition exams. So in puzzles also, you will be given a set of instructions, right? And on the basis of which, we have to make an arrangement. You can say arrangement only, you have to arrange them or like you will be given like, the, okay, take example of this question only. You are given four persons. They are accountant, swimmers, lecturer, football, they like football something. And you have to arrange them that, like who likes what. Okay, like four persons are there, one, two, three, four. Their likings are given to you. And you have to arrange them who likes what. So there can be like three things given to you and you have to arrange them. So today we are going to do this topic, okay. Let's start with the questions. It will make you more clear. So for the starting, we are taking a very simple question to explain the topic, okay? Now, let's start with the question. There are four persons, A, B, C, and D. One of them is lecturer and plays football and cricket. A and B are accountants. A plays badminton. Both the accountants are swimmers. D is bank clerk. One accountant also plays tennis. The bank clerk plays carom and is a swimmer. All the four persons play two games each and follow one profession. So this was the information given to us, okay. So we know one thing, we are given four persons, A, B, C, and D, and their professions are given to us like lecturer, accountant, and bank clerk, right, bank clerk, and they play some games and we are given the name of the game. So now we have to arrange them accordingly, like which profession is of whom and which game is played by whom, right. So let us make a table. There are four persons, A, B, C, and D. Okay, let us make a table type. A, B, C, and D. Right, now we have to make the range. Now, one of them is a lecturer. We don't know who is lecturer. So let us write here. One of them is lecturer, and whoever is lecturer plays football and cricket. Okay, A and B are okay. I'll see this. All the four persons play two games. Okay, one profession and two games. Right, now A and B are accountant. A and B are accountant. That means A is accountant. A is accountant and B is accountant. Okay. Then it says A plays badminton. It is so short given information. We can write like this only. A is playing badminton. Both the accountants are swimmers. A and B are accountants. That means both are swimmers. That means A is a swimmer and B is a swimmer. Okay. D is bank clerk. D is bank clerk. And one accountant also plays tennis. These two persons are accountant because one. Okay. How we consider only these two persons are accountants? Because we are having four persons. One is bank clerk, two are accountants according to the question, and one was lecturer. So if A is accountant, B is accountant, and D is bank clerk, that means lecturer can only be C. C can only be lecturer. Now, if C is lecturer, he is playing football and cricket, right? It was given in the starting of the question. Lecturer plays football and cricket. Now here it is given, all the four persons play two games each. That means only two games and not less than two and not more than two. Now see, A is playing two games. That means no more game can come here. Okay, no more more game can come here. This is final. A's arrangement is final. Here, one, they play for one more game because two games. C's two games has been finished and now we are having these two games. Okay. Now, these bankers, one accountant also plays tennis. Now, we know that only two persons are accountants, A and B. And A is already, and one of them will play tennis because one accountant plays tennis. A is already playing two games. That means tennis cannot come here. That means B is playing tennis. Because B is accountant also and B can play two games. Now, the bank clerk plays carom and is a swimmer. Bank clerk is a swimmer. And he is playing carom. Two games done. So we have plotted all the information. We are having professions of all the four persons. We are having two games each of all the four persons. Right. So this is our arrangement. This is what constitutes puzzles. Now let us solve the question based on this information. Now, this type of questions can be asked. Once you made this arrangement, on the basis of this, you will be asked questions. So here is the first question. Who is lecturer? So, who is lecturer? C is lecturer. So answer to this question is C. Who cannot swim? Who cannot swim? This is can. Who cannot swim? We can see from here. A is a swimmer, that means A can swim. B is a swimmer, B can swim. And D can swim. That means only C is there who can't swim. Right? Next is, who plays tennis? Who is playing tennis? Only B is playing tennis. Answer to this is B. Then last question is, who plays badminton and is an accountant? Who plays badminton? So badminton is played by A and he is accountant also. So answer to this question is A. Right? Who is the lecturer? C was the lecturer. Who cannot swim? C cannot swim. Who plays tennis? B is playing tennis. And who plays badminton and is an accountant? A. A plays badminton and A is an accountant. So this is this was a basic question of puzzle. This is how you are required to solve a puzzle question. Okay. Now let us move on to another question. Okay. Let us first read the question. A, B, C, D, E, F, G and H are 8 students of a school. They study in standard 6, 7 and 8 with not more than 3 students in one standard. Each one of them has a favorite subject from physics, geography, English, Marathi, mathematics, chemistry, biology and economics. One thing is clear. See, we are having 8 students and 3 standards. And it is given to us that each standard with not more than 3 students in one standard. That means there can be, there are 8 students, there can be 1, 2, 3, and there will be 2 standards having 3 students each, and there will be 1 standard having 2 students each, because there can be more than 3 students in one standard. So we can take this arrangement. Each one of them has a favorite subject from physics, geography, English and Marathi, mathematics, chemistry, biology and economics, and not necessarily in the C model. Now, okay, this one is clear now. 3, 3, 3, because if we make one person is here and all the other standards are having 3 persons, then it will account to 7 persons only. And to adjust one more, we will add this here. So that means if we want to adjust only 1 student in one standard, that means there will be 4 students in some standard. But according to question, there cannot be more than 3 students. That means only this case is possible, in which 2 standards are having 3 students each and one in which 2 students are there. Okay, now, D likes chemistry and studies in standard 8 with only H. B does not study in standard 7. E and A study in the same standard but not with B. C and F study in the same standard. Those who study in standard 6 do not like mathematics or biology. F likes physics. The one who studies in standard 8 likes English. C does not like geography. A's favorite subject is Marathi. And G does not like biology. Now let us make the arrangement. See. First of all, let us make a table. Let's make table based on the divisions, because divisions are set 6, 7 and 8. Okay. 6, 7 and 8. Sorry, let me make a good line. Make a table, okay, always. It will make a question be neat and there will be no any confusions. Okay. Sorry for the tilted line. Now let's solve questions. What it says? It says D likes chemistry. Okay, D likes chemistry and studies in 8th standard. Studies in 8th standard. That means D is studying here and D is like chemistry. Okay, we do not know where this arrangement is. There is a case there can be three students here or two students here. Okay, we know this one thing, that out of these three standards, there are two standards having three students each and one standard having two students each. Now, which standard is having that two students only, we do not know till now. Okay, now this says D likes chemistry and studies in standard 8 with only H. This means that H is also studying in standard 8, and with only means there are only two students here. D is studying in standard 8 with only H. That means there is no more students in standard 8. That means other standards are having three students each. Clear? Now B does not study in standard 7. If B is not studying here, and B cannot study here because two places are already filled, that means B is studying here in standard 6. Right? E and A study in the same standard, but not with B. Now E and A study with same standard and not with B. That means standard of E and A is different from that of B. That means they cannot be in 6th standard. That means they can be in 7th or 8th. And there is no place for more students in standard 8. That means E and A are studying in 7th standard. Okay? Now, C and F study in same standard. Now, C and F are already studying it off. Also studying in the same standard. Now we need two places empty in one class and there is only 6 possible. That means C and F are coming here. Right? Now, what else is given to us? Those who study in standard 6. Okay, that means only one chair is left. Then who is left? A, B, C, D, E. That means F is studying here. F is here. That means G is studying here. Okay, wait, let me write again. Here B, C and F, here E, A and G, here D and H. Okay, now what is given to us? Now we know the standards of every person, but now we need to find out the subjects studied by them. Those who study standard 6 do not like mathematics or biology. That means these three persons do not like mathematics or biology. Okay? This B is not for biology. F likes physics. F likes physics. The one who studies in standard 8 likes English. Who is studying standard 8? D and H. And one from them likes English. D is liking chemistry. That means only H is left to write English. C does not like geography. And A's favorite subject is Marathi. That means A likes Marathi. And G does not like biology. Now see. If G is not liking biology and C is also, and F is, then nobody in standard 6 likes biology, right? B, C, F do not like biology. Now G also do not like biology. Then only C is left who can like biology. E is left who can write like biology. Clear? Nobody from this can like biology and G does not like biology. Then only E was left to like biology. Now, G does not like biology. Okay, this was information. Now G does not like geography. Here maths cannot come. Okay, let us write the subjects left. Physics, bio, Marathi, chemistry and English turn. That means maths is left, geography is left and economics is left. Right? Now, let us go through information once again. Those who study standard 6 do not like mathematics. Now, these three persons do not like mathematics. That means only G can like mathematics. If G is liking mathematics, okay. Now, G, here it was given, C does not like geography. Only B and C are left and only two subjects are left. Now, if C is not liking geography, that means B likes geography because someone has to like geography. And then we are left with only one, that is eco, that means C likes eco. Economics. So, this is our main arrangement. B likes geography, C likes economics, F likes physics, E likes biology, A likes Marathi, G likes mathematics, D likes chemistry and H likes English, and these are their standards. B, C and F in 6th standard, EA and Chin 7th, DNH unit. Okay, now let us solve the question based on this arrangement. Which subject does H like? H likes, where is H? H, H likes English. H likes English. What is G's favorite subject? That is, G is here. G's favorite subject is math. In which standard does C study? C is here and C is studying in 6th standard. Then last question is, who study in standard 7th? So E, A and G study in 7th standard. So this was the arrangement. H likes English. G's favorite subject is math. C studies in 6th standard. And E, A and G studies in 7th standard. You might think that it takes time to draw an arrangement to solve a puzzle, but you know, all the time is just to draw this puzzle. Once this is drawn, your 4 or 5 questions take just seconds to solve. So ultimately the average becomes 0. Okay, so make the if you can, in the examination, if you can see the puzzle solvable, to solve that puzzle, then the question will take just seconds to solve, and these questions will be accurate also, and they will be fetch you marks. Okay, now let's do one more question, and this is a pretty big than above. Okay, this is a big question than above, and this will call for good arrangement. This is a good arrangement question. 6 persons A, B, C, D, E and F are expert in 6 different fields. Fields are P, Q, R, S, T and U, not respectively. Won different prizes: Kalinga Award, Gandhi Peace Prize, Vyas Samman, Kabir Samman, Iqbal Samman, Saraswati Samman, though not respectively. C and F have not won Gandhi Peace Prize and Iqbal Samman. The winner of Kabir Samman is expert in the field S, but he is not certainly E and B. D and A have won Kalinga Award and Kabir Samman, though not respectively. The expert in the field Q and E have won Gandhi Peace Prize and Iqbal Samman, though not respectively. A is expert in field P, and the winner of Iqbal Samman is expert in the field of T. We are given now 3 things: 1, persons; 2, fields; and 3, prizes. Now we have to make arrangement of these 3 things. Okay, let's start then. Let's write first the name of the persons as we do. Persons are A, B, C, D, E, and F. A, B, C, D, E, and F. And okay, these are the persons. Now let's plot the information. C and F have not won Gandhi Peace Prize. We can make one more line here, one for the professions and one for the prizes. This one for the prizes. Clear? Okay. Now C and F have not won Gandhi Peace and Iqbal Samman. This is C and this is F. If we say here prizes will come and here fields will come, that means C and F, C is not Gandhi, not Iqbal Samman, and F also not Gandhi and not Iqbal Samman. Okay, write in short form, it will save your time. Okay, do not go on writing Gandhi, G-A-N-D-H-I. It will take a lot of time. Now, CFF not won Gandhi Prize and Iqbal Samman. The winner of Kabir Samman is expert in the field of S, but he is certainly not E and B. First of all, let's write here, whoever wins Kabir Samman is expert in the field of S. And now, E and B cannot be. E and B are not winners of Kabir Samman. That is E. E is not winner of Kabir Samman. And B is not winner of Kabir Samman. Okay, D and A have won Kalinga 1 and Kabir Saman, though not respectively. A, okay, here this is a social information. A is expert in field P. We can write here. A is expert in field P. And winner of Iqbal Saman is expert in the field T. Whoever wins Iqbal is expert in field T. Okay, now B and A have won Kalinga 1 and Kabir Saman, though not respectively. Now that means D and A, Kalinga and Kabir Saman is between D and A. And we know that whoever, that means here it is D and A. Kalinga and Kabir are what? Is distributed between A and D. Now it cannot take Kabir Saman. Why? Because whoever is having Kabir Saman is expert in the field of S. But here A is expert in the field of P. That means A can have only Kalinga Saman. If A is having Kalinga Saman, that means D will have Kabir Saman. And if D is having Kabir Saman, that means D's expert field is S. Clear? D and A have one Kalinga and Kabir Saman do not respectively. This means, do not respectively means you have to arrange that who is winning Kalinga and who is winning Kabir from D and A. The expert in the field Q and E have won Gandhi Peace Prize and Iqbal Saman, do not respectively. Now that means E is now tie between E and the expert in the field Q. Whoever is expert in the field Q, expert and E have won Gandhi Peace and Iqbal Saman. Now, okay, we know one thing that C and E, C and F cannot win Gandhi and Iqbal Saman. C and F cannot win Gandhi and Iqbal Saman. That leaves us with only two persons, that is B and E. That means Gandhi and Iqbal Saman is between B and E. Right, now, this question also tells us that B and E, that two persons are winning Gandhi and Iqbal Saman. Now, that means that E is not expert in field Q. Because according to the question, expert in the field Q and E have won. That means these two are different persons. That means if Gandhi and Iqbal Saman can come here only, right? And that means B is expert in Q because one was E and one was expert in field Q. Now, who is having which award we don't know. Okay? Now, next is A is expert in field B and winner of Iqbal Saman. Okay, now we are left with which Saman? We are left with Vyas and Saraswati Saman. Okay? Kabir Tan, Kalinga Award Tan. Right? Let's see which Saman we were having. We were having Kalinga, Gandhi Peace Prize, Vyas Saman, Kabir Saman, Iqbal Saman, Saraswati Saman. Right? Now, C and F have not won Gandhi Peace Prize. C, F, F, no, Gandhi and Iqbal. Now, okay, we were having this. Now, Gandhi and Iqbal Saman are not won by C and F. That means they are winning either Vyas Saman or Saraswati Saman. C and F are C and F, either Vyas or Saraswati. Either Vyas or Saraswati. Right? D and A, sorry, the winner of Kabir Saman is expert in the field of S. Kabir Saman, expert in the field of S. But here is certainly not E and B. D and A have won Kalinga and Kabir Saman. D and A have won Kalinga and Kabir Saman. The expert in the field Q and E have won Gandhi Peace Prize and Iqbal Saman, though not respectively. A is expert in field P and winner of Iqbal Saman is expert in field T. Now we know, we left this information. Now we know that B and E, out of from B and E, one is winning Iqbal Saman. Now, B cannot win Iqbal Saman. Why? Because B is expert in Q. And in the question, the one who is winning Iqbal Saman is expert in the field of T. That means if E is expert in T and E is winning Iqbal Saman. If E is winning Iqbal Saman, that means Gandhi Peace Prize is won by Q. Okay? That means Gandhi Peace Prize is won by Q. Sorry, B, who is expert in the field of Q. Now, we are left with only R and U. That means C and F are expert in either R and U. This means, if C is expert in R, then F is expert in U. If C is expert in you, then F is expert in us. Same term. If C is expert in Vyas, if C is getting Vyas Samman, then F will get Saraswati Samman. If C will get Saraswati Samman, then F will get Vyas Samman. So this oblique sign shows it that one from R and U will come here. Okay. Now this is our final arrangement that we made on the basis of the given information. Right? You want me to read that? A is expert in P, Mani Kalinga. B is, okay. C and F are not, let's check, let's verify first. C and F have not won Gandhi Peace Prize and Iqbal Samman. Yes, C and F are not winning Gandhi and not Iqbal Samman. They are getting one from Vyas and Saraswati. The winner of Kabir Samman is expert in the field S. The winner of Kabir Samman is expert in the field of S. Yes, and he is certainly not E and B. Yes, because he is C, he is not E and B. D and A have won Kalinga Award and Kabir Samman. D and A have won Kalinga and Kabir Samman. Yes, we plotted right. The expert in the field Q and E have won Gandhi Peace Prize and Iqbal Samman. The expert in the field of Q have won Gandhi and E have won Iqbal. Yes. A is expert in P field and winner of Iqbal Samman is expert in T. Winner of Iqbal Samman is expert in T. So this is our main arrangement. Now, on the basis of this arrangement, let's solve the questions. Want to have a look? Okay. Now, who has won Vyas Samman? Now, we do not know who has won Vyas Samman. So, the answer will be C or F. Okay? Answer will be C or F. In the question, you will be given option like either C or F. If like this is not given, only A, B, C, A is given, then there will be option like cannot be determined. Okay. Who has won Vyas Samman? C or F has won Vyas Samman. Who is the winner of Gandhi Peace Prize? Gandhi Peace Prize, Gandhi is here. And winner is B. Gandhi Peace Prize, winner is B. D is expert in which field? Here is D. And D is expert in S. D is expert in S field. The person who is an expert in the field P has won which award? First of all, we have to find out who is expert in field P. So, A is expert in field P and he has won which award? He has won Kalinga Award. He has won Kalinga Award. And who is expert in the field of T? E is expert in the field of T. So, on the basis of the above arrangement, we made this, we solved this question. Right? So, in this question, we have to arrange three things, right? We have to arrange people, their fields, and their prizes. And in above questions, in first question, we also arranged three things. Here we arranged people, their profession, and their games. We made the arrangement, and on the basis of which we solved the questions. Then we did another question. Here we have to arrange students according to their standards and their liking of the subject. We did that and then we solved the questions on the basis of this arrangement. And then again we did a question in which we have arranged people, prizes and fields. So this was what puzzles are. You will be given a set of instructions and you have to just arrange them. So just go with the flow, go how the question says, and in the end just apply your reasoning and solve the arrangement. Right, so this was a video on puzzles. I hope everything is clear. And thank you for watching the video and all the best for your preparation.